Good morning, class 5 students. In the previous videos, I have already solved exercise 10A and 10B. Today, we are going to solve exercise 10C. 10C is what? The topic is division of decimals. Okay, division of decimals. Already in exercise 10B, last two questions were on divisions. Here, this exercise is completely on division. So what is given? 1a, the format is given 8 0.48 divide. So see, first is given 0, it is given already 0.06. you have to place the decimal point correctly in this question. So you have to place the decimal points correctly. So here given 0.48. After point, how many digits? 2 digits. So here we'll put after, before 2 digit we'll place the point. In the book you see a little gap is also given, 0, then little more gap, big gap, then 0.6. So from here easily we can understand where we have to place the decimal. Again in the next question you see 4 dividing 49.6. 49.6 is divided by 4. So here given 12 and 4. So after point, after decimal one digit, after decimal it is one digit. Okay, so others you will do by yourself. Now divide and check with the multiplication. Question number 2 is first you have to divide and then you have to check with the by multiplication that your answer is correct. 82.17 divided by 9. So 9 82.17. now see, 9 9 81, 2 minus 1 is 1, 1 comes in down. Now next, when this one will come in down, the point will shift here. Okay, 2 minus 1 is 1 we got, and then when this one will come down, this point will shift to after 9. Now we got 11. 9 1 is 9, 11 minus 9 is 2, 7, 3 9 is 27. So our answer is 9.13. So 9.13 into 9, this 2, this divisor and this quotient, if we divide, if we multiply, we'll get the dividend 82.17. See, 3 9 is 27, 7 2 carry. 9 plus 2, 11, 1, 1 carry, 81 plus 1, 82. So it is checked. Now again you see question number 2C, 272.22 divided by 6. So 6, 272.22, see. First, we will take these two digits, two numbers, 27, 6, 4, 24, 7 minus 4 is 3, then 2, 32, 5, 6, 30, 2, 2 comes. Now, next 2, when will come, the point will shift to here after 45, okay. Now, you got 22, 3, 6, 18, so 4, now this 2 comes, 42, 6, 7, 42, so our answer is 45.37. now 45.37 into 6 for checking, 6 7 is 42, 2, 4 carry, 3 6 is 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 4 carry, so 22, 2, 2 carry, 5 6 is 30 plus 2, 32, so 3 carry, 3 4 6 is 24, 25, 26, 27, 272.22 is the answer. Now question number 3, divide until the remainder is 0. Remainder is 0. Okay, so 90.3 divided by 6. So similar, 6 1 just 6, 3 0 30, 5 6 are 30, finished. Now point will shift here and 3 comes down. Now 3 is smaller than 6, 3 is smaller than 6. The decimal has already shifted, 3 is smaller than 6, so we took 0. Then for point, for decimal we'll get an extra zero. We'll get an extra zero. Okay. Now 30. 5 6 are 30. 5 6 are 30. So remainder is 0. So 90.3 divided by 6 is 15.05 is our answer. Now we have 3G, 2.67 divided by 5, divided by 5. So 2 is smaller than 5. That is why we have taken 0 first. Now we will take 6 also. So before taking 6, the decimal will shift to here. So now we have 26. So 5 5 is 25. 1 7 17. 3 5 is 15. 7 minus 5 2. 2 and 4 decimal we got 0. 5 4 is 20. In this case, as you have to continue the divisions till remainder is 0, until your remainder is not coming 0, you will get unlimited number of zeros for decimal. Unlimited number of zeros for decimal, here 0, again if you need, again 0, like this you can continue till your remainder is not 0, till your remainder is nil. Okay, so now 2.67 divided by 5 equal to 0.534. Now divide. So already in the last video, exercise 10B, I have told that when any decimal number is multiplied with 10, 100, 1000 like this, then the point is shifting to right side. Now here, if the decimal number is divided by 10, 100, 1000 like this, any number, then the decimal is shifting to left side. Now depending on the number of zeros. Okay, so here you see 42.8 divided by 10, we have 10, so decimal will shift to left side one digit, so 4.28. now see D number, 256 divided by 1000, we have 3 zeros here, 3 zeros, and we do not have any decimal number, so we have converted this one and into decimal number as 256.0. 256 is a whole number, 256.0. So now the decimal number, the three digits, so the decimal number is shifting to three digits left. Now that means the decimal is coming before 2. Before 2 means, for any case, before 2 means what you have to do? You have to take 0. So 0.256 is our answer. So here you see another question given, I missed it. 42.8 already shown. 42.8 divided by 100. Earlier it was divided by 10, now it is divided by 100. So 100 means 2 zeros, it will shift to left side 2 digits. So 0.428. Again, for this D number, this one also I have missed, 25 divided by 1000. So 25 divided by 1000, so 3 zeros here. So now see, we have only 2 digits. We do not have 3 digits here, but we have 3 zeros. So I have converted it into whole number as well as, I have converted it into 3 digits as well as a decimal number. So we have taken 0 to 5 and then 0.0. Then for 3 digits, decimal is shifting to left side 3 digits. So 0.025 is our answer. Clear? Now fill in the blanks. Question number 5 is fill in the blanks. A number is 0.6 divided by 10. 0.6 divided by blank, so 0.06. So as we can see, answer is in between 0.6 and 6, 10 came. So 2 digit here, here is 1 digit. That means this decimal is shifted to left hand side naturally. So 0.6. So 1 digit shifted means 10. Here you see 68.14 divided by blank equal to 0.6814. 6814. We have 68.14. Here 6814. That means the point has come from 68 from this poor place to before 6. That means how many digits it has shifted? 2 digits shifted. So we have taken 2 zeros. That means 100. So the rest of the questions you will do by yourself. Thank you.